viral hepatitis, commonly with a hepatitis B and a hepatitis C. In the United States, it's probably more common with a hepatitis C, and we have a lot of achievement in terms of the treatment for the hepatitis C. So a lot of exciting and very effective medications have come out. It's really promising for people with hepatitis C. So the hepatitis B is a little bit different. This is a chronic condition. It's more common in the Asian population. However, because of the immigration, we do see a lot of hepatitis B infection in the clinic as well. And this patient needs, the care is slightly different than the hepatitis C because of the nature of the disease. So I feel like the viral, the hepatitis is quite interesting in terms of their management. Chronic hepatitis B depends on, this virus is because of it's a DNA virus, so it's very difficult to use the medication to clear this virus. That's why it's very hard, not like hepatitis C, it's very hard to cure hepatitis B. Hepatitis B management is different based on the viral replication, based on different phase of the hepatitis B infection, and also depends on the patient's other the conditions such as co-infection with a hepatitis C and or with HIV. And the other thing for the hepatitis B is interesting is even if people have immunity or they have previous have the hepatitis B infection, when they become sick, such as when they are during the have a chemotherapy for other cancer, so the hepatitis B can be reactivated and people can be very sick from that. We do have treatment for the hepatitis B, and the other thing is for the hepatitis B, people don't usually, if it's a chronic infection, people don't usually have much symptoms. So what we typically do is to keep a close eye on the liver. It's because of hepatitis B can have increased risk for cancer even without progressing to cirrhosis. So this is one big part for compared to the hepatitis C. So this is routine follow-up and close monitor. It's very important for the hepatitis B management.